Well, hello, my fabulous friends. I hope you're doing well. I am so overjoyed to do this manifesting in May, manifesting Monday. It's our fourth one. Originally, my manifesting in May, my goal was to have 2,000 subscribers by the end of May. Well, I hit that on May 15th, and I promised to put my new manifestation goal in the comment section, and I didn't. I apologize for that, but my husband is my witness. My goal is now 5,000 subscribers by the end of May, and we are on our fourth manifesting in May. So I have an approximately a week and some to get another 1,000 subscribers. So that's my new goal, 5,000 subscribers by the end of May. No pressure on you. This is for me to manifest. So let's get right to it. This, I hope you're doing well with the manifesting in May. Let me know how you're doing, or if you need any help, or if you've joined us. If you've joined us late, don't worry. You can start this process at any time. When you find it is the perfect time for you. So first thing I do is I look and see what's blocking you. Why have you not reached your manifestation? Or how can you enhance your manifestation if you have? Let's see the general energies around your manifestation and manifestation in me. And on this fourth manifestation Monday, and we have five Mondays in May, so we'll have a bonus week next week. Manifestation in May. What are the energies surrounding us this week? Those of us who are using our manifestation in May energies. Okay. Let's see. Stag spirit, leadership. Oh, I love this. This almost goes really hand in hand with last week's energy. And the stag was in there and he was in the background. And now he's come forward. And now he's come forward. So this is step into your power. I'm getting a feeling here. Some of you are having imposter syndrome. You know, I can't do it, or, you know, I'm not good enough. I'm stammering, right? No, step into your power. Step into your leadership role. You can do this. You can do this. And I keep getting step up, because the last card, when he was in the background, well, now he's in your face, right? Now he's stepped up. He's stepped up to the challenge. Step up to the challenge. Don't be afraid to be colorful. Look at the colorful colors on this stag. Don't be afraid of your masculine energy, even if you are a female gender. Don't be afraid of your masculine energy to get what you want, to ask for what you want. This is a, you know, don't be afraid of that. Sometimes we have to bring out, all of us are a combination of masculine and feminine. And when it's balanced, it's great. But sometimes we have to be one more than the other, depending on the situation. And in this situation, the leadership, you have to bring up more of your masculine qualities. That doesn't mean you have to be a bad person or aggressive or mean. It just means you have to stand your ground. Stand your ground. Know that you have everything in you to manifest whatever you want. I'm almost getting a lightning feeling from these. Like, don't be surprised as once you stand up for what's yours, it will come to you very suddenly. I think that what they're just, the manifestation energies are telling us is own it. Own it. It's yours. Own it. Stand up for it. Step forward for it. Don't be afraid of it. You know, sometimes we ask for something and we're afraid we're asking for too much, or there's no possible way we can get that. And if you go back to the beginning, to week one, you'll see that I said, just start with something small. Just start with something small and see how that manifests. And once you get the hang of it, then continue to increase. So if you have manifested something small, it's telling you go bigger. Go bigger. You can do it. Don't be afraid of it. Don't be afraid. Do you think this stag looks afraid of anything, or do you think he's leading the pack? You know, he's not so far behind he thinks he's first. He knows he's first. He knows he's taken that leadership. Stag spirit. Don't be afraid. Also, put your head down and get to work, right? When they need, that's what these antlers are for. It's not to decorate your den with. It's when they put their antlers down and they go, they put their head down and they go to work when they're trying to keep another stag away or to protect themselves from a predator. So I was also getting, put your head down and get to work. But yeah, I'm getting a lightning feeling here. I think once you step into that power, I think once you step into that ownership, own it, you can do it. If you can think it, you can do it. Trust me on that. Of course, I mean, you can't, you know, if you are $20,000 in debt and you're like thinking, I want $1 million. Technically, yeah, you can do it. Will you? Probably not. So being a leader is owning your own truth as well. So get down, put your head down, get busy and get to it, own it, be in your power. Might have to pull up a little bit of that masculine energy and to get it manifesting for you. Don't be afraid of it. Don't be afraid of it. Very, very nice card for our fourth week. So I'm going to continue with the pulp tarot. So as not to confuse us, and also manifesting in May is, it's always wise to stick with the same thing when you're manifesting with your tarot cards, because they already have the energy in it and they will understand what you need to do next. So what are our next steps in our manifesting? If you haven't received your manifestation yet, these are your next steps. These might be your blocks that you're having. These might be things that you need to look out for. Like last week's was really good, that maybe you've received the wrong information and you need to find new information. So let's see what's going on this week. So obviously we've got some leadership. And I'm really getting a message that some of you might be feeling the imposter syndrome, you know, that you're not good enough, or who do you think you are? And I think we need to shake that off a little bit when it talks to your manifestations. So here we go. Manifestation in May, our fourth Monday in May. Manifesting Monday. What are our blocks? What do we need to pay attention to this week to get our manifestation? Very good cut. I love when they spread like that, because they're like, yes, let's talk, let's chat. Oh, Page of Cups in reverse. Did you get some surprising news or news that kind of upset you and now it's kind of toppled everything? You know, so maybe if you're trying to manifest Monday money, maybe you got an extra bill in the mail, for example. You know, if you're trying to manifest, you know, a partner, maybe somebody turned you down, something disappointing happened, and let's see how that's affecting you. Yeah. You know what? Then you went into a shell, and that's what's happening here. Again, I think this is that initial message of imposter syndrome is really playing here, because that is sneaking away with things. So you might be feeling like you're sneaking away, or you're being sneaky about things, or let's see what else. Six of Pentacles upright. Yeah, you know, I think, I don't think you're giving your all in this. You're giving it a little bit, and you got this little bit, and you're like, this will never work. Or, you know, maybe a little bit of your manifestation happened. Let's say you're asking for $1,000 and you got 200 or something, and you think, well, a little bit it's working, but I think something happened with this news that is bothering you and creating a block. Yeah, for sure it is, because we're going from 6 to 4, so we're going down the scale. Yeah, I think, you know, especially if you're dealing with money, if you're trying to manifest money, I think something showed up. Maybe your manifestation was sort of starting to work, and then now it's not again. And so you're like, this is not going to work. I'm not doing it right. I'm not smart enough. I don't know if this will ever work. And so now what you're doing is you're closing the flow. When you go from a higher number to a lower number, you're shutting things down. And I think it was something to do with some news. Nine of Pentacles. You know, I again, this is screaming at me, imposter syndrome. Somebody told you something. Who the hell do you think you are? You really think he's going to go for you? Do you really think you can collect that money? And that person could have even been you. This could even be your inner child, something that you, because the cups are young people, maybe a message that you learned when you were a child. Money doesn't grow on trees. Who do you think you are and all that? You know, you were a chubby child. What makes you think somebody would be interested in you? So I think this is, if it's not actually a physical thing that happened, like a bill in the mail or somebody declining your advances, or maybe you applied for a job and they weren't interested. If nothing like that happened, I want you to look at your own inner self-talk that you learned about yourself as a child, or that you were told about yourself as a child. And to this day, you just keep it as the truth. Because that isn't you. This is you. This is you. Because see, we go, here's a little bit, and then you close the flow. So we go from 6 to 4 to 9. So what we need to do is we have to open up this flow again. We have to open up this flow. We have to get rid of the imposter syndrome. We have to, this is like self-negative talk as well. The Seven of Swords upright. We have to get rid of that and open up the flow. And guess what? Here you come. Everything you want. Great success. Money. This is sometimes the single female, but she's in her power. Remember, this almost reminds me of the wannabe queen. If I don't have any queens in the reading, I sometimes read this as the queen because she's the queen of her own domain. She's been very successful. I'm thinking more like goddess but anyway, she's been very successful. And it's not just in money. It's the way she holds herself. She knows she's in her power. And that goes back to the leadership. She owns it. She owns it. I've been very, very successful. So I think what's happened here is you've had a little bit of success with the manifestation, but something, there's your negative self-talk, or you actually did get a bill in the mail or something, and now it's kind of shut it down a bit. And you really need to get over this, whatever this happened, to get to this. Because you're there. You showed up on the reading. Oh, the Tower in reverse. Yeah, I was exactly right. The Tower in reverse. I think you started to get a little bit of your manifestation. And who do you think you are? Who do you think you are? We got this negative self-talk. This will never work. See, you only got $200 instead of $1,000. See, he texts back, but he didn't say he wanted to go on a date. See, you know, you applied for that job and you haven't heard back. Who do you think you are? And that's the Tower. And I'm almost getting a feeling in this that the answer wasn't really no. It's what you made of the answer that is creating the block of flow here. Seven of Cups, yeah, confusion. You don't know what to do next. And rather than continue on with your manifestation, you're just giving it up. You're just giving up. It's like, yeah, because this is the choices, confusion. This is mental and emotional energy around it. Maybe you didn't focus in on exactly what you wanted. Maybe you're saying you wanted a man with money. Well, is that money or a man do you want? Right? Because money and man, or money, or, you know, do you want to get a partner? Or maybe you want, you know, a job that will pay you a lot. Well, what do you want? Do you want a job or do you want money? So I think what you need to do is become really a lot more clear, because the tower originally was called the hand of God. And the tower doesn't always have to be bad news. If you won the lottery, the tower is great. That's a tower moment. If all of a sudden you got headhunted by the job of your dreams, that's a tower moment. That's, you know, upset your whole life, right? Now you got to move to another place, might affect your family. Tower moment isn't always bad. A tower moment is just the hand of God, something that just all of a sudden hits you. And I think in this respect, because we're talking about manifestation, you are almost there, but you aren't allowing your positive tower moment to come and hit you. Right? Because we got this both in reverse, and it has a lot to do with imposter syndrome and messages that you learned about yourself when you were a child that weren't really good messages. And, you know, God bless our parents. They did the best they could. And I'm a parent as well. And I'm sure my children have things that I said to them that are swirling around in their head. And it's just the way of the world, really. And some things you might even just say accidentally, like, you know, don't quit being a slowpoke. And so then they think they're a slowpoke the rest of their lives, that kind of thing. Because your subconscious mind does it when you're young, it takes everything as truth, whether it is or not, you know. So because this is the Page of Cups, so this is something that you learned as a young child or an actual bill in the mail or somebody who rejected you or something like that. But I think it's telling you you're very, very close. You're very, very close. What you have to do is focus on one thing. Focus on one thing. We've got a couple more weeks left here in May. And again, you can start this at any time. But I'd like to see what happens if you just focus on one thing. Do you want that new job or do you want more money? Do you want, are you looking for a rich partner or do you want a partner or do you want money? Right? So let's see where that goes. Oh, the sun in reverse. Yeah, you guys, you are darkening your own shadow. You aren't allowing yourself, your full self. You aren't allowing the sun to come and shine on you. You aren't allowing the sun to clear up all those old shadows. When the sun is in reverse, it's night. It can't light up anything. And look at that. It's on your tower and on your confusion, on your mind here. So this is saying you are doing it to yourself. You're not allowing the sun to shine on things to help it grow. What does the sun do? Once you plant the seed, you need to water that seed, and then the sun will help once that seed emerges. The sun warms up the soil, the seed emerges, and the sun helps grow the seed. You aren't nurturing the proper seeds. Or the seed starts to come right out of the ground and you're like, oh, that's not enough, or it's not working. You're not allowing the sun to do its job to grow the seeds that you're planting at all. And you're doing it all in your thoughts and your mind. Absolutely. You're doing it with your thoughts, your emotions. You're not putting the proper emotion into what you want, and you're blocking the flow. Because let's face it, this is cups. So cups is emotions, and all the cups are empty, so they're running out. You're not putting the proper or even any emotion into your manifestation. And then therefore, the sun can't help you if you have no emotion in it. Or if your emotion is fear, or your emotion is, you know, disappointment, because I'll never do that. I'm not good enough for that. That'll never happen to me. I'll apply for that job, but that will never happen to me. What emotion are you putting into that? You're blocking the flow, and therefore the sun can't help you grow your manifestation. Look at even our stag spirit. This is at nighttime too. And interesting, I said this looks like lightning. It would happen fast. And look at the tower has lightning as well. Once you step into owning it and your leadership, you know, Oh, and justice in reverse. That's karma. Justice in reverse can be karma. Something's not happening because of some karma that you have, so you might have to clean it up a bit. And that might be karma is also has to do with your negative self-talk. Karma also has to do with your past things about your past. And I think you aren't doing yourself justice. What you need to do is suss out the what's going on here. Do you think money is evil? Do you think you're not good enough? Do you think you're not smart enough? You know, do you think you're too fat? Do you think you're too ugly? Do you think, you know, you'll never find a nice guy? Do you even think are there's no nice men left, right? Especially if you're looking for a male partner, because we started off here with masculine energy and leadership. Know yourself, know thyself. So you need to suss out what are your negative self-talk that you've had for a very long time. Maybe you think the root of money is evil that you learned as a child. Maybe you learned that there's not, you know, it's not handed out, you know, evenly or whatever your negative self-talk is about money. So we're doing person, place, or thing. If your negative self-talk is there's no good men, all men cheat. That's all preventing you. You aren't nurturing your seed at all. You know, and then so what happens is the sun can't come out to help grow your seed and move your things forward. Because the sun card, I mean, in this card, it doesn't depict it very well, but in other cards, it's the horse is moving forward. And so that's moving your manifestation forward if the sun can help it grow. But when the sun is dark and it's nighttime, nothing's growing, man, nothing. And so this might be a little bit of karma that you need to clean up, you know, again, using your mind and thoughts. Look and see what thoughts you have regarding what you want to manifest. Clean those up, and then you'll be surprised how fast this grows and how fast you actually become the Nine of Pentacles, the person who is very successful, owns it. She owns it, man. And look at, she is a good balance of feminine masculine. Look at her stance there. She's working her masculine there and her leadership. Would you dare argue with this person, or do you think she really cares what you have to say about her? No. She's got the money. She's got the good. She's got the success. She's got time. She dresses well. She's got it all. She's got it all. And this is where you're starting, and this is where you can ending. You got to just stop that block, that what you're the flow that you're blocking with your thoughts and minds and emotions, and not allowing that boom to happen to you, because it's coming. Trust me, it's coming. All right. Well, I hope you enjoyed this. If you enjoyed this, please give it a thumbs up. If you're working along with Manifesting in Me, put a comment down below what you're working on and how it's working. Or if you have any questions, I don't mind helping you out with that. Share this with somebody who you think work with somebody. Get a buddy system going and see what you guys can manifest here. Thanks for watching. Take good care. Bye for now.